One of the first things that people studying English learn is that the game they call football is called soccer in North America.
Soccer has been popular for more than 100 years, and today it is probably the most popular sport in the world.
Every 4 years, teams from all over the world compete in the famous World Cup. The Cup is a series of games in which teams from many countries play to see which is the best. By one estimate, almost 1 billion people watched the 1982 championship game on television. People in Asia had to get up in the middle of the night to see Italy beat West Germany on TV in a game played in Spain. The World Cup began in Montevideo, Uruguay, in 1930. At the time, it did not seem like a true world competition since only 13 teams decided to play, and 8 of them were from South America. The team from Uruguay won. In 1934 and 1938, the Cup was held in Europe. More than 30 teams played in each of these competitions, and Italy won both of them. The larger number of teams meant that some rules had to be changed. There were too many teams playing, so they had to have elimination matches first. Some of the games were played in countries other than the host countries. This system is still used today, and only the 16 teams left after elimination actually compete for the Cup. There were no World Cup championships in 1942 or 1946 because of World War II. The Cup itself was hidden during the war. This beautiful cup is about 10 inches high and has the shape of Nike, the Greek goddess of victory, on it. It is named for a person who helped organize the World Cup, Jules Rimet. When the Cup play started again in 1950, there was little enthusiasm. It was like 1928 all over again. Only 13 teams competed, the games were in Brazil, and Uruguay won. But the worldwide interest in soccer came back during the next 4 years. By the time West Germany won in Switzerland in 1954, millions of people wanted to go to the matches. In 1958, when the games were held in Sweden, interest was once again very high. 53 teams wanted to compete. Many elimination matches were held in different parts of the world to get the number of teams down, and only the last 16 teams went to Sweden. This was the first time that the world saw Pelé. His team, from Brazil, won the Cup for the first time that year, and Pelé became the greatest soccer player of all time. In the past 30 years, soccer has become the sport of the world. Each World Cup is more successful than the last. Since 1966, probably one quarter of the world has listened to or watched the championship game. In the 1970s, Pelé retired from the national team of Brazil and became a professional player for a team in New York. Soccer wasn't very popular in the United States at that time. Few North Americans knew about this fast-moving sport. There was no money to pay professional players, and there was little interest in soccer in the high schools and colleges. When Pelé and other international stars began playing in various U.S. cities, people saw how interesting the game was and began to go to the matches. Today there is a professional league called the North American Soccer League, NASL. It is common for important games to have 50 to 60,000 fans. Support from the fans is important to soccer. The fans cheer enthusiastically for their favorite players and teams, who respond by playing better than before. In most World Cups, the home team, or the team from the host country, usually plays better than most people expect. In 1966, 1974, and 1978, the home teams of England, West Germany, and Argentina all won the World Cup. It is common for people to close their stores and stop working during games. Some people feel that their national soccer team represents their country's honor. North American teams have never been as good as teams from other parts of the world, but this may change. Many North American high schools and colleges now have teams, and student interest is high. Fans in the United States enjoy sports which are hard and fast, and soccer is a fast sport which demands strong, hard play. U.S. interest in it will surely grow. As all soccer fans know, the greatest teams don't always win. Their fans' enthusiasm and their own desires sometimes help teams play better than normal. In the 1950 World Cup, for example, most people thought that the team from England was the best in the world. The U.S. team surprised everyone by winning its match. That loss stopped England from winning the cup. This, of course, did not mean that the U.S. team was the best in the world. The United States lost to Chile in its next game. Then the Chilean team lost to Spain, and Spain finished fourth in the final result. Uruguay won the cup. The World Cup is called that because teams from every continent have played in it. However, since the cup began, all of the winning teams have been from Europe or South America. Teams from Asia or Africa always do well, but they haven't yet won. Mexico played surprisingly well in the 1970 Cup, which it hosted, but it wasn't among the final four teams. The largest crowd ever to attend a soccer match was at the World Cup final in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, on July 16, 1950. 199,854 fans watched Uruguay defeat Brazil by a score of 2-1. The following incidents show how serious some people are about soccer. During the 1960s, a player for a team from Derby, England, was fined $2 for smiling at a referee during a match. In another incident in Greece, a referee feared an angry crowd after a match, so he dressed himself as a Catholic priest and tried to escape to Athens by ship. The fans found out where he was and threw fruit at him before his ship sailed. Level 1, Beginner. Basic Vocabulary. About 300 basic words. Congratulations on your dedication and good luck. Text read in American English. Level 1, Beginner. End of text by Easy English Abreu.